Hi students, welcome to Chemistry Online. In previous class we discussed chemistry practicals. Before that class we discussed stocks of concentration of the ore and remaining concentration of the ore we discussed now, and concentration of the ore can be done by remaining different process, so we discussed. Then in this class we are going to discuss extraction of the iron. So in previous class what we discussed means leaching, and in this class what we are going to discuss means extraction of iron from its ore. It is nothing but iron pyrites. So first, it is very important question, how iron is extracted and what are the stages involved. In each stage what type of chemical reactions is going on, then how finally iron can be divided into how many types, how iron can be divided into types, we are going to discuss in this class. This is extraction of iron from its ore. So iron ores already we discussed, hematite, magnetite and iron pyrites. So in this class we are going to discuss iron is extracted from hematite. Hematite is nothing but Fe2O3. Okay, see, first you have to know extraction of iron. Extraction of iron. So in this process we are going to use a equipment which is nothing but a blast furnace, which is nothing but a blast furnace. Now I am going to draw blast furnace diagram. See how blast furnace is. So it is called blast furnace. So it is the equipment we are going to use to extract iron from its iron ore. So here we are taking in this one, we are taking ore plus calcium carbonate CaCO3 plus coke mixture. Ore means here we are taking Fe2O3. Okay, it is a ore plus CaCO3 plus coke we are taking from upper part of the blast furnace. Lower part of the blast furnace, these are called tuyeres. Through tuyeres we are sending hot air sent into the blast furnace. Then the coke is mixed with the hot air and which gives a high temperature. So here blast furnace containing three parts. Blast furnace containing three parts. So three parts. Three parts in blast furnace. First one is a cup and a cone arrangement. Cup and cone. Cup and cone arrangement. It is cup and cone arrangement. It is used to take ore and CaCO3 and limestone into the blast furnace. And then second one is a shaft. Second one is a shaft. Shaft means shaft is useful to shaft which contains two parts. Shaft, it is a upper part, it is a lower part. Upper part of the shaft contains one outlet for escaping waste gases. Lower part of the shaft contains two tuyeres. The tuyeres is helpful to sending hot air into the blast furnace. So it is upper part and it is a lower part. Upper part is which contains low temperature and lower part is nothing but a high temperature. Next, third one is hearth. Third one is nothing but a hearth. Hearth means this part which is useful to collecting solid waste. It is called solid waste. It is called solid waste. It is called pig iron. Pig iron. So the molten state of iron is called a pig iron. Okay, so here it is a bottom of the furnace, platform of the furnace. Okay, so here blast furnace contains three parts. This is three parts means first one is cup and cone arrangement. It is cup and cone arrangement. Next shaft, next hearth. So here this is called, this zone is called reduction zone. So this is a zone of reduction. Zone of reduction. So this zone means 500 to 800. So 8 to 900 is called zone of reduction. This is a zone of slag formation. Slag formation. And it is a zone of fusion. Okay. So three zones are present. At low temperature, zone of reduction. Reduction can be done at 5 to 800 degrees Kelvin, zone of reduction, and 8 to 900 Kelvin, zone of slag formation, and 9 to 1500 Kelvins, 9 to 1500 Kelvins, zone of fusion can forms. Now, so what type of reactions can be done at different zones? Now we are going to discuss. So chemical reactions. Chemical reactions can be done in blast furnace. So first at 500 to 800 Kelvins, at 500 to 800 Kelvins, what type of reactions can be done means, see here,
Fe2O3 at 500 to 800 kelvins. Fe2O3 reacts with CO gives rise to Fe3O4 plus CO2 is formed.
So you have to balance this. If you take 3, then what happened? Then what happened? 3 2 is 6. If you take 2, 2 3 is 6. Then 3 3 is 9. So 2 4 is 8, 8 plus 2, 10. So then it is a balance.
Then again Fe3O4 reacts with CO gives rise to Fe plus CO2.
Then how many here? If you take 3, Fe3 is balanced. Next, if you take 4, then 4 carbons and 4 plus 4, 8, 4 is 8, it is a balance.
Again Fe2O3 reacts with CO, then what happened? So FeO plus CO2 is formed.
Then Fe2Fe, if you take 2, then 2FeO plus how many oxygens? 2 plus 2, 4, 3 plus 1, 4, then it is a balance. These are reduction reaction. These reactions can be takes place at a zone of reduction.
These reactions takes place at a zone of reduction. Zone of reduction.
Zone of reduction. Then
at 800 to 900 kelvins, so it is called a zone of slag formation. Zone of slag formation.
At a zone of slag formation, here
CaCO3 can be divided into CaO plus CO2.
Here we are taking CaCO3 added to Fe2O3 now. Then it can be divided into CaCO3, CaO plus CO2. At the same time, so CaO reacts with SiO2, which is present in the impurity. Then which gives rise to CaSiO3. It is nothing but a slag. Calcium oxide reacts with SiO2, which gives rise to CaSiO3. At the same time, CO2
plus C gives rise to 2CO is formed.
2CO is formed. So these type of reactions can be done at a zone of a slag formation.
And finally, at 900 to 1500 kelvins.
900 to 1500 kelvins. So here
FeO reduced with Fe plus CO.
FeO reduced with Fe plus CO. And then C plus O2 gives rise to
CO2. Then CO2 plus C gives rise to 2CO.
So this type of CO and CO2 gases are escapes from here, which is outlet is provided. So here FeO plus CO gives rise to Fe plus CO2 also formed.
FeO plus CO gives rise to Fe plus CO2 is formed.
So it is nothing but at
900 to 1500 kelvins, it is at 800 to 900 kelvins, it is at 500 to 800 kelvins.
So here formation of a slag, which is nothing but a solid waste, it is floats on the iron, so it can be separated. Here pig iron is formed. Here forming iron is called pig iron, which is separated. It is higher weight than the solid waste, so it is collected at the bottom of the earth at nearly 2200 kelvins temperature is provided. So above 2200 kelvins, which is near earth,
above 2200 kelvins, which is near hearth.
It is called hearth. So here molten iron is collected.
Here molten iron is collected.
Molten iron is collected. It is called pig iron. So here you have to know pig iron. Pig iron. The iron which contains 4% carbon as impurities. The iron which contains 4% carbon as impurities.
Impurities plus other impurities, less other impurities
is called pig iron. Next you have to know cast iron. Next you have to know cast iron. Cast iron means the iron which contains 3% carbon impurities.
3% carbon impurities.
As a impurities are called a cast iron. Next, finally, you have to how cast iron is prepared means, sir, the cast iron is made from pig iron. To the pig iron, you have to add scrap iron and coke. Then that will be reduced to iron containing 3% carbon as a impurities. Then it is called cast iron. Next, you have to know wrought iron.
Wrought iron. It is the purest form of iron. It is a purest form of purest form of iron.
Okay, which is 99.5% pure. So this is the way extraction of iron can be done by blast furnace. So different reactions can be takes place in the blast furnace. At a zone of reduction, at zone of slag formation, it is at zone of fusion.
It is a zone of fusion.
Okay, zone of fusion. So above 2200 kelvins near hearth, molten iron is collected, which is iron is in the form of liquid state. Liquid state means molten state. That is nothing but that is very soft. That's why it is called pig iron. Pig iron. So from pig iron, the percentage of impurities can be reduced, and you will get a pure form of iron, which is a wrought iron. Nowadays we are using in construction purpose. Wrought iron. Nowadays we are using in construction purpose. This is extraction of iron. Extraction of iron. It is a blast furnace. So blast furnace, which is used for roasting of the ore, roasting or smelting can be done in the ore. Okay, so this is nothing but extraction of iron. So once again, this is the blast furnace, which contains three parts: cup and cone arrangement, shaft, hearth. It is cup and cone arrangement. From here to here, it is called a shaft. It is upper part of the shaft. It is lower part of the shaft. It is a hearth. This is called a hearth. At near the hearth, above 2200 kelvins temperature is produced. Why? Because here we are sending hot air now. So from top of the furnace we are taking coke. Then hot air is mixed with coke, which gives us much temperature. So here low temperature, here high temperature. Different zones are present in the blast furnace. First one is zone of reduction. This is called zone of reduction. It is called zone of slag formation. It is called zone of fusion. It is called hearth. So at different stages, different irons reduced stage by stage, which is like this. Okay, so it is today's class.